and a very special performance by John Farnham and Olivia Newton-John. And two of Melbourne's biggest stars have been spreading some Christmas cheer where it's needed most. John Farnham joined Olivia Newton-John for a special concert for patients at the cancer centre that bears her name.
It was a surprise visit, bringing with them some much-needed festive cheer.
No press, no press, no comment.
Aussie superstars Olivia Newton-John and John Farnham clearly happy to be back performing together and to brighten up the day for patients at Olivia's Cancer and Wellness Centre.
Don't fall back.
Don't fall back, kids. I'm in a hospital.
Take the first one.
Joking around before getting down to business.
Silent night.
It's the first time the pair have performed the carols they've recorded for their new album. Their hand-picked audience lapped it up.
Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
I've been inspired by Olivia for a number of years, so I feel... it's exciting. Just my breath's taken away.
Patients and their families keen to capture the one-off concert.
Jesus Lord at thy birth.
And to meet the stars.
Hi everyone, happy Christmas, safe and peaceful New Year.
The new album, Friends for Christmas, is out now. Andrea Edwards, 7 News.
Lovely.
John Farnham and Olivia Newton-John have recorded some of the most popular songs of all time. Now the Aussie icons have collaborated for a Christmas album. Olivia and John sat down with our very own Angela Bishop to talk about their very long friendship. As well, John revealed a secret about his biggest hit.
It was December 1967 when 18-year-old John Farnham released a novelty song that would become the biggest-selling single in Australia at the time.
If not for you, the sky will fall. Rain would gather too.
4 years on, and Olivia Newton-John had similar success with a track written by Bob Dylan. Over the decades, the two chart toppers have combined their incredible talents, first at the opening of the Sydney Olympic Games.
And then, of course, the main event with Anthony Warlow.
Anthony Warlow.
What about the age of
reason? Which was great fun. We had a lovely time doing that. And then we did the Two Strong Hearts tour.
It's been said John and Olivia have a chemistry and friendship you just can't fake. And now the pair has joined forces for a new Christmas record. The last time John recorded a festive album, he was the king of pop.
46 years since you made a Christmas album.
Yeah, I didn't bring it up for you to bring it up again, though. No, you cut that bit out.
He was a child. That is a long time between Christmas drinks.
Oh, no, I've never had that long between Christmas drinks ever. When I made that album, I wasn't allowed to drink.
The album is full of John and Olivia's favourite festive songs.
We're able to put our own little marks on them. You know, we didn't want to copy everybody else doing them. So good old-fashioned traditional Christmas songs. Everybody knows all of them.
Let's get physical.
With record sales over 100 million and a successful film career, it was only a matter of time before Olivia's journey to stardom would be turned into a mini-series.
I won't watch it, that's for sure. It'll be years till I watch it. I can't watch things about myself, but it's a very odd feeling. I guess you stick around long enough, it's gonna happen, but... I imagine it's not too long before people are proposing to do one of you.
Oh, it's not.
You're the voice.
Wait till I'm dead.
That's your call on it?
Yeah, yeah. Because
it's a good ending.
That's a good ending, you know. Who is dead? Whoa! See, and Wheatley could take it on the tour. Jack's dead. Oh, give me a break. This could work.
Thank you very much for what you've done for this song. I love you.
And speaking of Australia's unofficial national anthem, John let me in on a secret about his great hit.
I got it very late in the piece when I was recording Whispering Jack, and I just sang a song six times, I think, and we used take four. But I just went full-blooded with it because originally I sang the chorus, whoa, in falsetto, and my falsetto is very weak. And I think that's why I wasn't really happy with it. So I just went full out, full blood. Didn't know I could hit those notes before I tried it. It worked out that way, but I owned that song. When I heard it, I thought, oh, I've got to sing this. It's just perfect.
Whispering Jack has just turned 30 and remains the biggest-selling album by an Aussie artist. But don't expect John to have the CD in his car.
I haven't listened to an album since, or any of my albums, since I made them. You know, you spend however many weeks making them and then you walk away from it. I mean, you feel like such a knob if someone walked in and you were listening to your album.
Hit after hit, and what about that spectacular mullet he used to rock?
The mullet with the white pants?
Wow!
How 1986 was that?
Amazing! Yeah. Oh, it was just and how handsome and ripped was he back then, too?
Oh, he's still handsome.
No, of course he is.
He's
of course.
Just ripped up. I can say that because I know him. I've seen him for a while. How are you? Just singing better than ever.
Yeah. He's brilliant. Still got a voice on him, doesn't he?
Oh, brilliant.
And we love you.
That was the best thing at the Song Awards, our awards the other day.
The Arias.
The Arias. Yeah. Just brilliant.
Wouldn't it be great to get him on the show?
Ooh.
Yeah. Denise, we need you to make some calls.
All right, I'll have to go through Jill first.
Yeah.
You know, fun fact, Johnny Farnham grew up in the suburb near mine, and my choir master at St Mary's Children's Choir was Johnny Farnham's singing teacher or choir teacher. There so basically me and Johnny Farnham.
Yeah. Like that.
Yeah.
Can you ring him too?
Didn't work out quite so well for all of us. But,
John and Olivia's Friends for Christmas is in stores now, so pick...
Great Christmas magic from two Aussie legends. Olivia Newton-John and John Farnham reveal the true story behind their special bond.
The spectacular.
Well, they are both absolute icons. Olivia Newton-John and John Farnham, two of our favourite citizens, two wonderful voices. And now they have a special gift for us, a collection of fabulous festive songs produced by the brilliant Chong Lim. Let's catch up with Olivia and John, who are friends for Christmas.
Silver bells, silver bells,
silver bells.
What is it about this time of the year?
Oh, gosh, the Christmas songs, I mean, is there anyone that hasn't sung Christmas carols when they were young and Christmas songs that doesn't take you back to that time with your family?
Every one of these songs is knowable by most people. And so, I mean, you may not remember all the words. I don't remember all the words, but I know every part of the
You don't remember all the words if you're the voice.
No, that's true.
Do you remember the first time you became aware of this young lady here?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I think because Olivia was probably one of the very first Australian entertainers to make it big, huge in America. And a pretty, pretty, pretty lady. And she was lovely to watch and lovely to listen to.
Thank you. I'll pay you later.
You two are both icons. Do you ever, like... call each other up for advice?
We keep in touch on the phone and the fax and all the fax. The phone and the you know
email.
That's what I meant.
I don't
Twitter. I don't Twitter. But if I just want to say hello, I'll give her a call.
You've had a busy time, really. The celebration of Whispering Jack and performing at the Arias, that must have been a blast.
Oh, it was unbelievable, and I was just blown away. by the reaction. I truly was. I didn't expect that at all. I mean, part of the reason I was so nervous, I thought, oh, gee, you know, what if it stiffs? What if they just sit on their hands? Every entertainer, every performer goes through that. I want it to work. I want it to capture people. I'd rather be booed off the stage than a reaction at all. I mean, it just reacts in some way. I'm going to wish I hadn't said that.
Your career has had so many reinventions. Just goes from strength to strength, doesn't it?
You know, it's funny. Every year I think that's it. Nothing else is going to happen. I remember after the Olympics, I thought, that'll be it. That's the highlight of my life and there'll never be anything else. And then something else happens. It's been amazing. I feel very grateful that I'm still singing and people are still turning up and I get to sing with John. And that's just fun. It's having fun now.
Christ the Savior is born.
Is this a toe in the water for more stuff together?
Well, there's half a foot in the water, mate. There's always a chance, but we've got nothing planned at the present other than, you know, another one of these next year. What I could do is advise people, don't buy it this year. Just wait for 6 months. It'll go in the discount bin. Then you use it for next year.
Did Farnham really say, don't buy my record?
I was only kidding. Please take that as a joke. I just did it to make her laugh.
Oh, aren't they lovely people, and what magnificent voices. They just sound like they were made to belong together. John and Olivia's Friends for Christmas CD is out now.
Stick that one right in the socking.
John Farnham and Olivia Newton-John have 100 years of experience in the entertainment industry between them. The much-loved Australian performers have been friends for decades, but only sang together for the first time in 2000 at the Sydney Olympics. They enjoyed the experience so much that they then did a successful tour together called Two Strong Hearts after John's hit song. And this year they've recorded an album of duets called Friends for Christmas. I spent some time with John Farnham and Olivia Newton-John in Sydney this afternoon. John and Olivia, lovely to meet you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
How did you two first meet each other?
We've been trying to remember this for the last few interviews. We can't remember.
We started making stuff up.
You met in prison.
Yeah, because we can't remember when we very first met. But I'm pretty sure you're right when you said in England. And if it's not, we've told that story all the time, so it's become urban myth anyway.
We were teenagers or like almost 20, at least I was, when I think I first met John and Jill in London.
With this particular project, where did the idea for that come from?
It was Dennis Hanlon, wasn't it, who's the head of Sony here, and he, according to John, plied him with some beautiful wine and asked him if he might do a Christmas record, because, what was it, 46 years since you've done one?
Yeah, the last Christmas album I made was apparently 46 years ago. I was really pleased when they brought that up. I was very, very happy to hear that.
He was a child, of course.
But of course I was a child. I was 8. Anyway, he said he'd be up for making a Christmas album, and I said, oh, that'd be fun, I think. He said, do you think Olivia, because we'd done the Two Strong Hearts tour and everything went so well, and I texted Olivia, do you want to make a Christmas album? Question mark. And got back in seconds, yes.
Sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace.
With technology these days, if you are recording an album together, do you have to be in the same location, or does everyone do their parts wherever they are?
You don't have to be, but we wanted to be, and I think that's what's made the difference in some. We actually sang live together through glass. That was important. Otherwise, it's very clinical, because I've done that. You have too.
Yeah, I have too. Yeah. And I think, you know, a duet is all about...
Playing off the other person.
Thank you. That was going to be a very unpleasant pause for a minute. it's having that compadre, that simpatico, you know. And I love her voice. I love her voice. And so she's such fun to sing with. And we were able to breathe together. And that's singing is an enormous. That's an enormous part of singing, is the breathing. And so we were watching each other breathe, looking each other in the eyes, singing these songs together. And I think it shows in the stuff.
We're breathing also.
Yeah. Yeah, we're going to call the next one Beating Hearts or something. Hopefully, Beating Hearts still.
Inflating lungs, can I suggest. Just because you're friends doesn't necessarily mean that you'll have chemistry on stage or that you can work together as an act. Can you figure that out
before actually trying it, or can you only work that out in the studio or on stage?
We tend to bring out the best in each other. I know that I used to like mucking around with my phrasing, and she'd look at me and go, oh, I'm coming at you, I'll sort that. And that was great fun, you know, and then she would do the same thing with some of the harmonies that she would come up with. It was just amazing, and you know, it would take me somewhere else. So we had a great time.
I'm such a huge fan of his anyway. I love his voice, and I've always admired him as an artist and a singer. So
when you are making or recording a song like The Voice or like Physical, do you get a spider sense at the time that, oh, this is going to be massive?
I didn't, but you know, I can speak for Physical. I thought it was a hit song, but I had no idea it was going to be as big as it was.
Nailed it on the head. Look, you know, I felt the same way about The Voice. I thought it was a hit song. I thought I have to sing this song, but you never know if it's going to be a hit. I mean, there are songs that I've knocked back that I've thought, ooh, don't like that one. And I think one of them was Wind Beneath My Wings. I got sent Wind Beneath My Wings. Not for me. I didn't see it. But for Bette, it worked a dream.
John, I was reading that when Whispering Jack came out that you were sort of on the bones of your
absolutely
bum at the time. And,
absolutely.
You know, what and the labels passed on it.
Yep. In fact, I was originally with EMI, and because I wasn't doing much, you know, kind of lapsed, didn't drop me. And Wheatley actually mortgaged his house for me to make that album. We had to put it out in a brown paper bag because they were, Johnny Farnham, are you kidding? Oh, no way we're going to play him. Fortunately, it got through.
Have you had moments in your career like that, Olivia, where you've thought, oh, gee, maybe it's done now, you know, it's as big as it's ever going to be?
All the time. And particularly, I think in 2000, after I did the Olympics, it was like I thought, that's the pinnacle. There's not going to be anything after this. I really believed it. And then I was offered a bunch of stuff, and it just kept going. But I often think that. Now I'm open to, you know, I'm really loving it and singing and performing. And I never used to really like live performance, but I have been enjoying it.
Given that you've both had those real peaks and also valleys over what are long careers, what do you think you've learnt about life through those experiences?
Oh, gosh.
Nothing's forever. But I think, that, you know, that's just basic common sense. Look, what we do isn't brain surgery. It's not brain surgery. I mean, it's entertainment. And you know, I try not to take myself too seriously. There are guidelines, but I know she's the same. And it's about for us. It's about connecting with people and trying to move them some way. Whether it's moving them to boo or moving them to shout hurrah, but not to sit there and give you nothing. It's not an ego trip, it is in its way, but you know, people come up to us all the time and say, sorry to bother you, but say, hang on, no bother at all. We've spent over 50 years of our lives trying to get people interested in what we do and entertain them. And when they are, why would we say, oh, I want to be alone, leave me?
I, like John, I like to sing a song that will make somebody feel something about something. You know, I do a song about trees and rainforest and about dolphins and things that I care about also that can make people feel something and think about something and just strictly entertain them, make them laugh and jump in their seat or whatever. But that's a pleasure for us.
That is. Yeah.
Well, it's been a pleasure to meet both of you. Merry Christmas.
Thank you, Lee. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to you and yours.
Olivia, you've worked with some wonderful people over the years. John Travolta, of course, Sir Cliff Richard, John Denver. Of course, you worked, as we saw in the intro there, with Anthony Warlow and John Farnham at the main event. You sung with John at the Olympics. Who do you think is the most fun you've ever worked with?
You want to answer this question very carefully indeed, dearie.
That sounds like a familiar voice. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome John Farnham.
Thank you. I'm sorry, I had to get in before you answered that question. And I was trying to think of a way to impersonate Warlock, but I couldn't do it. I couldn't look. Now, I bought my Sandy doll in. But I'm a little disappointed because I would have preferred Sandy 2, which is in a tight bracket. But the beauty of this one is there's a few moving parts. But I've left him. I left her in the box because I didn't want to wear him out.
haven't changed a bit. John? Just
don't get me into trouble, because this could go much further.
Just so that you don't feel left out, we have your own doll.
I thought I was going to get away with that too. Oh, gee, thanks very much.
That one only works if Glenn Wheatley's handling it, mate.
Well, yeah, OK. It's one of those.
So are you going out touring?
And it's your day. Yes, I'm going out touring, but are you having a nice time?
I'm having a lovely time.
Good.
Do you know your words?
What do you reckon?
Oh, I have trouble with them. That's why I do touring.
I'm shocking.
He's going on tour till June. Going on the road till June.
Yeah, well, I told Wheatley this was going to be the last one, and he went, no, which was typical Wheatley, and he said, well, it's going to be the last time. It's going to be a long time.
It's going to be forever, right?
Yeah, but it's been interesting the lyrics and stuff, and I have an apology to make to you, a public apology to make.
What's
to
that?
You. I never really got to work with you on the album.
I know. Well,
which disappointed me, and because I was in the middle of my one at the time, and I'd become terribly self-possessed, and I can't pull myself away from an album once I start it. And but are you finished?
I am finished.
Oh well, next
maybe
one.
Next time. Next time I'd love that.
Well, pick a day when I'm not working.
Thank
you.
All right. Well, thank you for that. That's really nice. Because I did miss you.
Yeah, well, I miss you too. Yeah. And because I love singing with you on the show, and I got a kiss at the end of each song, which was kind of nice.
Your album is going gangbusters, John. We should congratulate you on
it.
Give
him
a round of applause,
please.
And you recently played Kahuna?
Yes, I played Kahuna.
Were you discovered?
Yeah, I was discovered there. If you could use that word, uncovered would probably be
better.
A better word. But yeah, it was a unique experience for me. It was absolutely sensational. Everyone from the local area turned up, and it was it brought back a lot of memories. Some were good, some were bad, but it was unbelievable.
So now you're the big Kahuna there.
Richard's writing it down.
They've been trying to get you back there for years, have they?
They have.
The horses?
They're all very well. In fact, it's foaling season as we speak.
How gorgeous.
So we're having foals, and it's actually quite lovely. And I get to name some of them only if I'm really quick. And I just had a foal by a horse called Doc's Freckles Oak. And
it's an interesting name.
The horse's the stallion's name is Doc's. He's a Doc's Freckles Oak stallion, and so I called the foal that I've had from him my freckle, because I can't wait to go out on the road and for the judge to say, and here's John Farnham riding my freckle. Just appeals to my dad.
What colour is he?
It's a brown one. Little baby brown one.
No dots on it.
It was a classy show until a few minutes ago.
No freckles on it. No. The only freckles on it's me.
Yeah. Looking at you two sitting there side by side is a great sight. You're both Australian icons. I mean, the last time we really saw you two together was at the Olympics.
Everybody's an icon now. I mean, you know, there are so many Devons, icons and legends around. You only have to be in the business for 8 minutes.
Well, we'll agree to disagree on that.
I was being facetious. Thank you, Richard.
You two are both very special. I mean, those concerts, the main event, when you two were there with Anthony Waller. Tell me how much fun it was, the three of you getting up there night after night.
It was great, wasn't it?
It was an amazing experience. And I have to say, I mean, we were asked, in no uncertain terms, to do that again. I think we all really would have loved to have done it again. I know I would have. But I don't know whether we could have actually topped it.
It's a hard act to follow.
Yeah. Real tough to follow, and I would rather people remember it, or this is my feeling, remember it as it was. What I was frightened of with that whole thing is people walking away from main event again, if you will, or the second round,
second
or whatever they were going to call it, would have gone, it wasn't as good as the first time.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, and that first time is always, you know, something I'll never forget.
Yeah.
I wish I hadn't have said that.
John, thank you for being here. Yeah, I know it's very special for both of you.
It's my pleasure. And I wouldn't have missed this for the world. I really would.
Thanks for coming. I really appreciate it. Take care. See you. And good luck on your tour.
Thank you. Thank you for the ball.
Good luck with the tour. John Farnham on tour, of course, for the last time, or so he says, around the country.
I'm going to join the Seekers after this one.
All the best.
You shouldn't have said that either.
Still we'll read to come. About that tomorrow. Sorry, Richard.
It's your show.
Yeah, but you do all the talking. I mean, you just go ahead.
If you were going to stage a concert with two of the country's best singers, you would just go straight for Olivia Newton-John and John Farnham. No question.
Well, the superstars are about to hit the road on a national tour. We sat down with them to talk about their enduring friendship, performing in Vegas, and who is the boss on stage. You're the one that I want. You
are the one I want. They're the ultimate singing double act, joining forces for a brand new show. John Farnham has one of our country's most recognisable voices. As the only Aussie artist to score number one records in five consecutive decades, the height of John Farnham's success is matched only by the range of his voice. Million records sold, a string of big screen hits, and a sellout Las Vegas show, Olivia Newton-John is one of our biggest musical exports. Next month, the superstars are travelling the country with their Two Strong Hearts tour. And when it comes to his on-stage co-star, John's a little lost for words.
I mean, you know, I've always been in love with Olivia, always. I mean, it's funny, when we came into the studio today, there was a photograph with
Pat Carroll
and Derpy. And it was, you know, it was like, oh, I remember that. It's fantastic. And I get myself in the trouble now.
They've been mates for years. In fact, they've known each other so long, it's hard to remember where it all began.
Oh, gee.
It was so long ago.
Well, it was so bloody long ago. I mean, it was very
difficult. We were
children.
I think in England. I think we met in England.
It was
first.
In England.
We met in England.
Yeah,
we met in England.
Can you edit that bit out?
It was the 60s.
Pardon?
It was the 60s.
It was the 60s.
We met in the 60s.
I don't know. But
We've forgotten.
I want to bite my tongue off.
The show won't be the first time they've performed together. In 1998, the pair shared the stage during their main event tour. And their duet, Dare to Dream, was a highlight of the Sydney Olympics opening ceremony. But with so much history, who has the final say when it comes to putting the concert together?
I've been married a long time, longer than Olivia's been married, haven't I, right?
Yeah.
I'm used to saying yes to you. So I'm covered. I am covered.
Actually, it's been really great because Chung Lim has been putting together. He put the ideas of the show together and then he gave it to us to look at and see what we thought. And it just was perfect. It flowed together and we're doing each other's songs
and stuff. And Chong has been a real dynamo behind this. He's a genius, and I love the man very much indeed. He actually came to us both with a suggestion of Run, and so we opened the show together, and we finished the show together, and there are all sorts of interactions in between. We've got a name for us. You know, they call you J-Lo and your Ho-Ho and all those sort of things. Well, I think we should call ourselves Jolivia Newton-Jack. What do you reckon? Jolivia Newton-Jack. I know it's long,
sure,
but it's really catchy.
We'll
it's catchy. Let me take you to the wonderland that only two can
share. Olivia spent much of last year in residency at the Flamingo Hotel in Las Vegas. But don't remind John, who's still upset he wasn't invited along for the ride.
No, she hasn't, as a matter of fact.
You're always invited.
Ah, yeah. Now on the telly I am. Yeah. That's one thing that annoys me about it. You hit the nail on the head. I could have been in Las Vegas gambling my life away,
you know, going and watching Olivia work every night.
So, has John considered doing his own Vegas show?
Oh, gee. What? No!
There's a question.
No, nobody knows who I am over there. It was an interesting thing. I was once in Las Vegas, and Tom Jones, who I love, he's one of my favourite singers of all time, and I've worked with Tom a couple of times, and we were in the audience. Tom introduced me over the microphone, and the spotlight hit my brother-in-law, which is really funny. Because nobody noticed. Human Nature are a hit, and I recorded a song with them. Maybe I could go over and open up for them. I could come and open up for you. Here's a turn. Johnny Farnham and Olivia Newton-John in Las Vegas. Be great.
Oh, legend alert.
Joe Olivia Newton-Jack.
What? What? Yes.
Joe Olivia Newton-Jack.
Yes.
Oh,
my God. I don't know what you're talking about.
John.
Aren't they fantastic? What are you talking about?
That was John's name that he came up
with. Oh, right.
That was just contained in the package.
In the package.
The Two Strong Hearts tour with John Farnham and Olivia Newton-John.
Joe Olivia Newton-Jack. That's a great idea. Farnsie.
Well, April, it's sort of almost here, isn't it? Head to the Daily Info section on our website for all the details. Two Strong Hearts.
Good stuff.